Hello everyone, welcome to new tutorial series on Vue.js. So Vue.js is a progressive JavaScript framework. So why Vue.js? Get started, GitHub link. You can move to the GitHub repository of the Vue.js. And before we start this tutorial, what Vue.js provides us, like Vue.js is used at front end, or you can say also say at client side development. So Vue.js is used at front end or client side development. And it is approachable since you already know HTML and CSS or vanilla JavaScript. You can read the guide and start building apps and things in no time. Versatile, it like you can use a Vue.js between a library or a fully featured framework. So it's up to your choice at what, how do you want to use Vue.js. Or it is you can use it as a library or a fully featured web framework. It is performant. It has a 20 KB minimum size, blazing fast virtual DOM. That is a document object model and minimal optimization efforts. So like it's easy to use, quick learning. Vue.js is in competition with Angular and React, and the quality Vue.js has it that it has fast learning curve, that you can very fastly learn Vue.js and start building apps in no time, and it is comparatively easy to learn than other frameworks. So that is the quality Vue.js has. So it's up to you. You can use any front-end framework like Angular, React, or Vue, but Vue.js has a Vue.js has a better learning curve, that you can learn Vue in a very fast way and start building apps. And this would give you the architecture of how client-side development or front-end development is done. So next, before we start this tutorial, so you can refer to this GitHub link. This is the repository where you can refer all the codes for this tutorial, for this series. The title would be Getting Started with Vue.js, and description will be like, we will learn how to install Vue.js and render a simple Vue component at front end. So you can create a folder in your VS Code and start with the HTML file, that is index1.html. So before that, what you can do, you can start a HTML page, like you can simply start with the HTML tag, and HTML tag will have a header, and this header is like learn view, perfectly fine, learn view, and inside this you can put this inside a title. Okay, so I'll cut this, paste here, yes. So, and you can right click here, and what you can do, you can click on format document for the better orientation, and then you can have a body tag, perfectly fine. And inside a like you can type paragraph is equal to hello world, like hello Vue.js, a simple paragraph. And you can come to this page and refresh this page, so you will see hello Vue.js. So this is just for this is very static, so we can render this the same component via Vue.js, and for that we would render a Vue component on our front end. So what we can do, you can start on get start page, and you will find the Vue function. So just make sure this you are browsing for documentation 2.x, because we will start learning with Vue.js 2.x, and then we will like when we advance a level, then we can see how the implementation 3.x is done. But basically for your learning, you can refer to Vue.js 2.x. So what you can do, you can here on the left hand side, you can see the installation part, and you can click on installation. So the simplest way to install Vue.js is to just copy the CDN. So CDN works as a JavaScript script source, but like there are two types of CDN here. The one is like for prototyping or learning purposes, you can use the latest version, and for the production we recommend this. Like just what's the difference between the prototyping and learning purpose is like this will show the errors at your side. Like if you are using if you're using for the development, so here you can see with full warnings and debug mode. Okay, so like development version has with full warnings and debug mode, And in the production version, we have warning strip, plus it is performance wise optimal. But just in development mode, when you are in like development mode or development version, you can use one with the full warnings and debug mode. It will help your code, it will help you to debug your code very faster. So you can copy this one, you can copy this and put this inside your body tag, but make sure you put this at the end of the body. Okay, now for like I'll show you just for the like view appearance, reset zoom. Yes, so here you can see I have put this at the end of my body. Now I'll zoom this for the better view of okay, now you can see I have put this at the end of my body. Okay, and now I'll put another script tag, script, and I'll type I'll start with this console dot log script, just for my learning purpose, script started. And when I move to my browser, I'll refresh this page and I'll press Control Shift I. Either you can do inspect or Control Shift I. When I see here, it says script started, and you can see download the Vue DevTools extension for better experience. And like it is now the Vue.js is working in development mode, so that's particularly fine. So just for the confirmation, you can see that the Vue.js has been installed and it's running. Now, how a particular now before we get to this, so first I'll create a div inside my body, and what I'll give div ID is equal to my app, and what I'll do, I'll close this div. So I have a div with ID my app. Now I'll for this, now ID is very important with respect to Vue.js. I'll render a view component referring to this ID. So just for the demonstration, my Vue.js component will point towards the ID. Okay, so it will point towards the ID in the HTML page. Okay, so here you can see my Vue.js component will point towards the ID in the HTML page and will render the component for the same. Okay, so this is, you can make a note of this thing, that Vue.js component will point towards the ID in the HTML page and will render a component for that only. Okay, now so that's perfectly fine. So let's move to the code. Now what you can do, you'll create a component, Vue.js component. So how we will do that, so I'll show you how. Now what you can do, just for this tutorial, I'm creating a script inside the HTML page, so this would give you a better view. Okay, now what you can do, constant my view component, constant my view component. Okay, so this is work as a like it will have a new view, it will have a view constructor, and it will take a JSON object. So inside a JSON object, I will have three things. Like one is going to the element, which will refer to the ID. Okay, this would refer to the ID. Then I would have a data. So data would be like have a JSON object, so it will have all the data. And then third thing, I would have a methods. So this is how a particular view component looks like. So my view component is a new view. Okay, it calls a view constructor, and it will take a JSON object, and it will have an element which will refer to the ID. It will have a data, and it will have a methods. Okay, so what you can do, my element would refer to the ID. So the ID is my app. So I would copy this and I would simply paste it here, my app. Now I will have a title. Title is equal to learn Vue.js. Okay, Down Vue.js, and you can also have a like paragraph, okay, inside VS Code, okay, or you can say learn Vue.js using VS Code, okay. Now let the methods will remain empty for this time. And inside my app, what I can do when I have my view component refers to the ID. So this is my ID, my app. Now I can render this data inside that ID, or I can render this view component inside that ID. So I will put title here and I'll use h1 tag title. Perfect. Oh, sorry. So this is the title, and for this I'll use paragraph, and I'll use paragraph. Okay, graph is like this. So now this should work perfectly fine. I'll refresh this page. Okay, cannot find the element my app. Okay, I did a mistake. Since this was an ID I had used to, like what I told you, that this production version, this development version is live with full warnings and debug mode. So since this is in development mode, so it will provide all the warnings, and in the all the warnings, and it will be in debug mode. So you can click on this line. So this would refer to this. So where it has shown the error and cannot find the element my app. So let's put a since it was an ID, you had to put a hash symbol. Okay, let's refresh this page. So here you can see learning Vue.js using VS Code. So this is perfectly fine. I've got my result and the script had started. And to make sure, what you can do, you can also copy this and say script ended. Okay, so let's refresh this page. It says script started and script ended, and you can refer to this line. It will show you console.log script ended, and this is like how our view component looked. So you can also click on my view component, and when I type this here, you can see you get whole lot of things, and inside here you can see that element is div my app. So here it refers to this ID, and this is how you can have a look at this. And my view component dot dollar sign, you can put data, and here you can see that I have a data and it says a paragraph and title. So you can refer to this my view component dot data dot title and see Vue.js, learn Vue.js. Now I'll show you one thing. You can put the upper arrow key, and I'll put a new title, and you will see that as soon as I press enter, this title would get changed without refreshing the page. So it will only refresh the div. See, I'll put a yes. As soon as I click my view component dot data dot title is a new title, it changes to new title. Once again, in the same way, you can change the paragraph also. So thank you everyone for watching this tutorial. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.